Good evening. I'm Dave Phelan. I'm an elder here at Fairfield Christian Church, and we welcome you. And it's so encouraging to see so many parents and grandparents and friends on this very special evening. These kids are going to do a great job, and I'm so proud of them. I want to just mention, if you are not a member of a church family, Fairfield Christian Church and Fairfield Christian Academy, a partnership in so many, many ways. And so we just welcome you. We have our services Sundays at 9 a.m. and 10:45. We have inspiring messages and a great praise band. We have programming for elementary, junior high, and high school students, and we will save a seat for you. So God bless you all, and I think we're going to have one of the students come up and do a prayer.
Hello, everyone. Thank you guys so much for coming out tonight. My name's Carly Hours, and I'm a member of the high school choir, and I just wanted to welcome you all out here. I'm going to open with prayer, and then we're going to have the fifth grade band come. So if you all will close your eyes and bow your heads with me. Father, thank you so much for this day. Thank you for this opportunity to come and have an in-person choir concert, Lord. That is such a blessing in this time. Father, I ask that you would just help us to bless these people, Lord, that you would calm any nerves that we may have, Lord, and that everyone would just see our effort and see our work, that we would do this all for your glory, Father, and that we would sing and play our instruments all for your glory, Lord. Thank you so much for this opportunity again. In your name we pray. Amen. While they're exiting the stage, we had a little different year, as you've probably noticed this year. They just got their instruments 8 weeks ago. Did they do a great job? Yeah, pretty awesome, right? We started off the year with fifth grade band doing a lot of percussion because of just not having their instruments. And so they just started 8 weeks ago, and we're so proud of how much they've accomplished in a short time.
We've been working so hard. You can even say we're singing from the inside out.
Even though we started out quiet first.
I really think we found our voice. So here's the fifth through sixth grade choir.
Who can yank when close? See a humble who can yank when close? thousand times I fail, still your mercy remains. And should I stumble again, still I'm caught in your grace. Everlasting, your light will shine when all else fades. Never ending, your glory goes beyond all fame.
Good evening, my name is Evan Hammond. I'm in the seventh grade and I play the trumpet for the band. When I really enjoy band, and one of my favorite things about it is when we get to go to the pumpkin show. Now, sadly, this year we weren't able to do it. I'm excited for next year. I really like the pumpkin show because of being able to be with your friends, of course, eating the good food, and being able to march in the parade. I hope you enjoy our performance tonight.
While they're exiting, I want to take a moment to thank Ms. Copeland. I failed to do this the last 4 years. We've been together for 4 years, and she just does so many things behind the scenes that I wanted to take a moment to recognize her tonight. Thank you for loving our students. Thank you for rewriting band parts, sometimes at the last minute, changing keys. Thank you for doing that. Taking the lead on jazz band last year. Teaching me the ways of marching band and making it okay for us to adapt it, to make it the FCA way. So thank you for that. Willingness to jump in and help at every single music event. She's playing on the last song that the choir is gonna be singing, and I just asked her yesterday, but she's a professional, so we thank you for your help. playing pitches, tuning the band, going along with some of the crazy K through four fine arts motions, the laughter shared, the many memories, being a sounding board for me, but most of all, your friendship.
Good evening. My name is Emma Hetzler. I have been in choir here since fifth grade here at FCA, and I'm so blessed to be able to introduce the seventh and eighth grade choir. You know, it is so great to be able to see all of you here live Our last virtual Christmas concert was so crazy, and our last live concert was way back for Christmas, way back in 2019. It is so great that God has given us this opportunity to sing to you tonight. Amen? Two of my favorite things about choir are that I can sing and serve God while doing things that I love, and that I can share my voice with the school and everything going on with that. Tonight we will be singing Oceans and True Colors. This will be the smallest choir that you will hear from today, but trust me, we have big hearts. Thank you so much for coming, and we hope you enjoy.
Grace abounds in deepest waters. Your sovereign hand will be my guide. Where feet may fail, your fear surrounds me. You never failed, and you won't start now.
Strength in the morning, I will sing of your love, for you are my fortress, my refuge in times of trouble.
Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever you would call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior.
Thank you. you with the sad eyes. Don't be discouraged, oh, I realize it's hard to take courage in a world full of people. You can lose sight of it on the darkness there inside you makes you feel so small. But I see your true the sad ass. Don't be discouraged, though I realize it's hard to take courage in a world full of people. You can lose sight of it all, and darkness there inside you makes you feel so small.
Band, if you'll just come up and get in your spots and sit down without me giving you the cue and get ready to go, that'd be awesome. I would like to recognize Mr. Nolan this evening, if you'll go ahead and make your way up here. He has been our Band Booster president for the past 4 years. Yes, let's give him a hand. Lauren is graduating. She's a senior, so she's moving on. So for some strange reason, he doesn't want to stick around and be the president next year. I don't know what's wrong with him. Anyways, I wanted to thank him. Him and I and my husband and his wife went out to dinner, and I asked him if he would be willing to be our first Band Booster president and get it started. He said, yes, I will give you a year. I will get it started. I will get the bylaws ready. And you know how that goes. Here we are 4 years later. And you laugh because you know you've been there, right? I just want to thank you for your leadership, partnering with Elise and I, getting the bylaws written. So moving forward, that is in place. We have raised enough funds. We have 50 band uniforms out in the armory. Yes, that's a lot of money. And so the band is going to be looking really sharp next fall. So I hope you all will go out and see them at a football game. And I appreciate the time, vision, and energy that each of you have put into this to make all of that possible. So thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Coyne. Over the last 4 years, the band boosters have been in existence. I want to thank you as parents, because we've sent candy bars home, we've sent all kinds of fundraisers, and through that, along with the school partnering with us, we were able to purchase those uniforms. And if you haven't seen, they didn't want me to talk. So anyhow, out in the lobby, if you'll check that out, two things you can help us out with. As you know, this was not a normal year. And so our fundraisers this year, we had one Chipotle fundraiser back early, like late spring, I think, last year. But we have a Chipotle fundraiser in your flyer today. You will have a Chipotle flyer that you can actually go and take that this coming Tuesday. It's May 25th. And you'll be able to, from 4 to 8 p.m., if you'll take that over there, then we get like 33% of whatever you purchase. So let's go buy a lot of Chipotle on Tuesday. Also, we also have a virtual, we had a virtual concert for the band this past year for the fair. How many got to see that? See the band perform? That was awesome. If you haven't, it's still out there, so make sure you look for that link. But those uniforms came in after that, so next year they will look very sharp. One other fundraiser we do have going on is out in the parking lot when you leave today. We have a board with just some different amounts with envelopes on it. If you would do us a favor and just help us out with us purchasing the uniforms this year, it has depleted our funds. So we are looking to do a couple fundraisers here real quick at the end of the year, and then next year jump right back into it. But I really appreciate that. Now, in 2019, we established, the Band Boosters established a scholarship. That scholarship basically was providing a senior, and let me give you the requirements. They had to be a part of the band program for all 4 years of high school. They performed with the FCA band at all required performances. They demonstrated outstanding musicianship, leadership, and work ethic. Future plans also had to include enrolling in college within 1 year of graduating from FCA. They had to have a GPA of at least 3.0. And they also had to have a recommendation from our band director, Mrs. Coyne. So 2 months ago, in our meeting, we wanted to establish and honor Mrs. Coyne. So we're calling it this year, we're calling it the Heather Coyne Honorary Scholarship. And this year we have two recipients. I would like Sierra McQuarrie and Lauren Nolan to come forward. Really appreciate these two, and that's my daughter, so. But with that, I'd like to introduce the 8th through 12th grade band. Give them a hand.
I'd also like to thank Mr. Morris. He's back in our sound AV booth. He's kind of like the one-man show back there, doing everything. Let's give him a hand. He has been such a blessing to our choirs and our band and just all of our performances. He's excellent at what he does, and we are so privileged to have him. He's so amazing that, and he loves us so much, he wants to spend more time with us. He took 2 days off work this year to help us to volunteer for our concert, once at Christmas for our virtual concert, and then yesterday he took off work so we could do all of our sound checks yesterday, so you all could enjoy as much of your Saturday today as you wanted to up until 7 o'clock. So thank you, Mr. Morris. We appreciate you. Also, we decided to switch our program a little bit, and Night Singers is next.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do some time to do the things we never had. Do 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 do.
while they're exiting and getting in their spots, I would like for our five seniors to come up, please. I'm going to use my notes so I don't forget anything, and I say all the things I want to say. First of all, if any of you are in this room and had any contact or relationship with the five of these students, you'll know how amazing they are, each and every one of them. So when I speak first, I want to speak to all of you, and then I'm going to talk to you individually for a second. So I want to honor you and thank you. For your dedication and commitment. They are so dedicated. Their last day of school was Wednesday, but I asked them, and they, some of them hesitated, but most of them were like, yes, I can do that. We have a concert on Saturday. I said, can you come in Thursday and Friday to rehearse with us, and then Friday for sound check? And they were like, yes, we will be there. So that shows their dedication, commitment. They weren't required to be here, so thank you for that. They all have a cheerful disposition. If you'd see them without their mask, when they walk into the room, some of them are even doing it now, they have these great smiles. They have a servant's heart. They have come alongside, and I'm kind of speaking to them and you, so I apologize if I'm turning my back to you. They've come along, many of the students sitting up in our galleries can attest to this. They come along the younger students and they mentored them. They weren't asked to do that, it just naturally took place. So thank you for that, encouraging them, leading them. They are helpful. They all, in every section, we've got, if you're in band, raise your hand, just so people know. If you're in choir, raise your hand. Okay, so in band and choir, they hear things in their section, especially this year with the kids wearing masks singing, and then also in band, just us being spread out. I couldn't hear everything that was going on, things that we needed to fix or improve upon, and they were my second set of ears. I didn't ask them to do that. They just naturally did that, raised their hand in a respectful way, would say, Mrs. Quinn, I think I'm hearing this. Is this right? Is this what we're supposed to be doing? So thank you so much for being a second set of ears for me in all of our classes and helping us to improve. I want to thank you for your willingness to try new things. You guys have been great. Sometimes I throw out crazy ideas and you look at me and you're like, we're going to do what now? And I say, I'm so excited. And I say, let's just try it. They're like, oh my word, this is not going to work. And they try it. And sometimes we all bust out laughing because it was horrible. And then I say, what can we do differently? And then they always have an idea or suggestion and say, what if we try this? And we try different things. So thank you for your voice in our music and taking the pieces that we do and making them our own. Thank you for your help with that. Thank you for always giving me a student's perspective. Appreciate that. All right, I'm going to go through and say what I'm going to miss about each one of you. But I can't do it because, you know, the clock is running. We can't be here all night. So there's lots more things. But I'm going to go. First, I'm going to go with Anna. And Anna, I want you to tell us, you've been in choir. Can you tell them how long you've been, how many years you were in choir?
Oh, gosh. I've been doing choir here at the school since probably fifth grade. I've also done community choir for the last 9 years. Yeah, I'm a choir kid. And I will hopefully be doing that in college as well. So,
awesome. So, Anna, when I came, she was, I believe, in eighth grade and doing, well, yeah, they were all in eighth grade, right? Yeah, yes, let's do math. I teach music, not math, in case you're wondering. they've heard me say it a time or two.
she was with me in eighth grade, and then the last 2 years she's been in choir a semester here and there because of her schedule. I wish I would have had more time with you, Anna. She is excellent. She has an amazing alto voice. She helps lead our alto section. She strives for excellence. She is one of the ones that had heard a lot of things in her section this year when I couldn't hear it. But she would always stay after class, take part of her lunch period, and stay and say, "Hey, Mrs. Coyne," she pointed out in the music, and say, "Are we doing this? Are you wanting us to do this? I'm not hearing this. We're not doing this." So thank you, Anna, for being those set of ears again. Appreciate your commitment, your dedication, and I've enjoyed having you in choir. Yeah, let's give her a hand. Next is Ethan. And Ethan, tell us how long you have been in choir.
I believe since fifth grade.
You are correct. And he not only did choir, I just wanted to make sure I got it all right. Fifth grade, he's also been a part of our musicals. He also loves to introduce. Have you been to any of our concerts at all? I would ask the kids early if they wanted to introduce, and they would get nervous and shy, and they'd hide their head. He was always like, "I'll do it." So thank you for being willing to do that. He is the number one advocate for VeggieTales. And the choir is laughing. Here's why. I'm going to give you an example. Just Wednesday, I told the choir, they came in, I'm going to assign you your spots on the risers, and we're going to go through each concert song for small fixes. Ethan chimed in and said, so this is what he said, and he said this on many days.
Or we could watch VeggieTales.
That was all year this year. He was the number one advocate. And one day they did talk me into it, like before a break. But I appreciate his humor, his endless optimism, the way you look out for others, the gentleman that you are. When we would go on our choir field trip, and I would be lifting and wheeling the speaker, and you'd always come along and say, "Mrs. Coyne, let me get that for you." So thank you for that, and I have enjoyed having you in class. The other thing I saw from you was the way that you love others. We went to the nursing homes. You would always get down and talk to the residents and spend time with each and every one of them, so thank you for that. All right, next is Sierra. Same question. How long have you been in band?
Since fifth grade.
Since fifth grade, yeah, pretty awesome, right? I'm going to miss you being my interpreter. And what I mean by my interpreter, she somehow always knew what I was trying to communicate with the band, especially during marching season. And she would first ask a few questions, and she would say, "Is this what you're trying to get us to do, Mrs. Quan?" And I would say yes, and then she said, "Okay, hold on." And so she would turn and talk to the band, and she would tell them what I wanted them to do, or she would physically demonstrate what I was wanting them to do, because she had, again, the student perspective, and she knew what they were thinking. So she would show them, and then we would do it, and it would be way better. So thank you, Sierra, for being my interpreter. Thank you for, again, being willing to mentor. She went to our ACSI competition at Cedarville Music Festival. She was willing to play with some junior high students and be the high school leader in that. So thank you for doing that. She's also the number one marker offer of the lines for marching band. I know that's not a real title, but she would go out there and get everyone marked off on the lines without being asked. And then if she wasn't going to be there, she would get a backup. And she started this year training because she knew she was going to be gone. So she started training her number one sidekick, Caitlin, who is up there. And so then Caitlin started coming out, and she would start marking off. So thank you for your leadership and all the things that you brought to our ensemble. Next is Lauren. How long have you been in band, Lauren?
Since fifth grade.
There you go, since fifth grade. She is a person of integrity, true Christ-like character. The thing I appreciate about her, she's very observant, and a lot of times she would come into class, her cheery smile, you know, just making her way in. But several times, on several occasions, she came in and maybe noticed I was having a bad day for whatever reason she could tell. And she would always say, "Mrs. Coyne, are you okay? Well, then, of course, if you're emotional, you're about to cry, but you were just so touched that she would ask if you were okay. The other thing she would do a lot, especially again during marching season, noticing a theme here, she would see me as we were working on something, and she would say, "It's going to be okay, Mrs. Coyne, it's going to be okay." So yes, you know, reassuring me. So I appreciate you, your leadership, always helping the younger percussionists with their part. Anytime I ask you to move a piece of percussion instrument, do anything, you're always like, yes, and you're on it. So thank you so much for that.
Thank you.
Last but not least is Colin. This may take a moment. How long have you been in choir, and what other groups have you been in?
Choir 7 years, night singer 6 years, and then like 3 years in band. Musicals and dramas.
So Colin and I spent quite a lot of time together. I think last year we had three classes together. So four or five classes together last year. So he's probably graduating just to get away from me. but one of the things I'm going to miss the most about him is him correcting my grammar. It's choir was, yes, choir is always more funner.
It's not a word.
It's not a word. I would say choir is funner. He would say more fun, Mrs. Coyne. And again, this is why I teach music and not English. So he has been my grammar police since day one, always helping out with that. His willingness to do whatever I asked again, singing tenor, singing bass, playing an instrument, just being willing to do whatever I ask him. His ability to motivate other students to buy into what we were doing. The conversations we've had, especially this year, about God's word, worship music, and your newfound love of hymns. Love that. So thank you so much, Colin. Thank you, all five of you, for the unique ways you've made me a better teacher. There's a quote that says, "Life is a symphony, and the action of every person in this life is the playing of his particular part in the music." Thank you all for being such an impactful part of my symphony and giving me the privilege to be a small part of yours. I love each and every one of you. Thank you, guys.
Hello, everybody. I'm Sophia Kumler, and this is the high school choir. I hope that you will enjoy the songs that we sing for you tonight. Choir has been such a joy to me during this crazy year when things might not have gone the way we wanted it to, but I was able to come to choir class, and we were able to laugh with one another, we were able to sing with each other, and we were able to worship with one another. So I hope that these songs bless you as much as they have blessed us.
Thank you.
can call my own.
Thank you. heart, you can have my heart.
Wasn't that lovely? Yes, I'd give him another round. I'll try and talk and not get a little choked up there, but I'll tell you what, when I see the students just praising the Lord, that's why we're here. And so I'm so thankful for that. My name is Kate Kumler. I'm the secondary principal, and I am so thankful that all of you joined us here this evening. I'm so thankful that we were able to come and have an in-person concert tonight. It's so wonderful to see everybody here. I know there were lots of parents and grandparents and friends that were coming in, and I'm so proud of our students. Each group that got up this evening just did a wonderful job, and again, this was an unusual year, and so they had lots of challenges that they had to overcome, but they did it, they made it here, and we are almost to the last day of school, so I know they're excited about that. We're excited about that, too. Yeah, they'll clap for that, I know. But I just wanted to say Mrs. Coyne did a great job of thanking many people that I had wanted to thank as well, our sound team, Mr. Albert, who helped us get all of these chairs organized in groups. Thank you to our students and our parents. Thank you for complying and sitting where we were seating you today. I know that was a little different than what we normally do. But we also want to take a moment here and thank Mrs. Coyne and Ms. Copeland for all of the work that they've done. And I was told, yes, let's give them a round of applause. I was told Lauren Nolan and Sierra McQuarrie have something, so I can't see you girls, but if you could make your way, there they are. They want to do a quick little presentation to Mrs. Coyne and Miss Copeland. I'm not sure where Miss Copeland is. There she is. Yes. Mrs. Coyne and Ms. Copeland will be moving on from FCA this year, but we want to just thank them for all their years of service and for wonderful nights like tonight. So please give them another round of applause. We appreciate them. We certainly appreciate them. Those of you who have been here with us for many years, you've been to many concerts and many plays, and it's always been such a treat and a delight, and I always leave thinking, what a fantastic job they just did. So I appreciate everything that they've given to this program. And we also want to thank Mr. Reed, who helped. He had all the art out in the foyer this evening. Yes, please give him a round of applause for thanks. I hope you were able to peek at some of that when you came in this evening. A lot of our talented students have artwork that they're presenting out there as well. So tonight was just wonderful, and I'd just like to close this out with a word of prayer, and then we will be dismissing you from the back forward. So the band boosters, thank you to you as well, who are ushers tonight. You did a fabulous job, and we appreciate that. So they'll be dismissing you. We'll also be having the students, I believe Mrs. Coyne communicated that to the parents. They're going to help us break down things quickly so that we can get things ready for the church for tomorrow, so they don't have to worry about that, but it shouldn't take too long. And thank you to the church, also to Fairfield Christian Church, for letting us have this here tonight. So if you would, please bow your heads, and I'll close us out in prayer. Heavenly Father, you are so good, and you are so faithful. You are so caring. Father, thank you for being a God who is interested in our lives. A God who loves us, who walks alongside of us, who gives us your wisdom and protects us. Father, thank you for this year. Thank you for each of the individuals who are here this evening. Thank you for our students, our teachers, our parents, grandparents, church staff, school staff, Lord. Father, I just pray that you will walk before us into these summer months. I pray that you will protect us, that you will provide for us. And Lord, above all, just thank you for, like I said, being a God who's involved in our lives, enough so, Lord, that you sent your Son to die on the cross for us so that we can live with you in eternity. So Lord, we just hope this evening was glorifying to you. Please keep us safe as we head home this evening. And again, thank you for a wonderful evening. In your name we pray, amen. Thank you for joining us. So glad to have you here. And again, our boosters will be dismissing you from the back. Have a wonderful evening.